There's no country that doesn't have its ups and downs, or doesn't have its good and bad at the end of the day. For example, Canada is a very good place. I don't deal with the market. I have nothing to do with it. But the visa is a very good place. They have the post-study, they have the stay back and everything, but the visa stage is crazy now. And the rejection rate is very high. So a lot of people don't endeavor in this. And the rejection didn't even just become high because people started playing games with it. Same thing with Germany. I was shouting Germany, come Germany, 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 Germany. A lot of people took advantage of this and they listened to me. Some other people that did could not maybe afford it, or people that were there that have already failed or made the wrong decision. They are angry that people want to make the right decision and they discourage them from it. Some other people are too blind to see it. For example, you come to Germany now, you go and study because you say you got a free school. Don't go to private school. Ah, don't go to private school. You ain't gonna study water science, or you ain't gonna study library sciences, and you don't get a job. And you are blaming somebody that you did not get a job. How would you get a job? Did you make the right decision? So that's the same way people are saying Netherlands now, oh, it's expensive and everything. If you can afford it, you go for it because the opportunities outweigh the cost. So, if you can't afford it immediately, think of how to afford it rather than just rushing to a cheap country that has no benefits for you. I have a lot of students that are calling me from Russia, from Cyprus, from Turkey, from Dubai, trying to get here, that if they knew, they would make the right move. So, take your time in making the right move. There's always a bad example, there's always a good example. Learn from the people that have good examples. You should take a leap from them. AOC or nothing.